Is it yourself, Eamon Holmes?
Hello.
Any chance of a photo there, Eamon?
Sure, no problem.
Great. Me and Eamon Holmes.
Okay.
All right, cheers. Thanks very much, Eamon.
Bye-bye.
Bye. You wouldn't take another photo there, Mary Eamon, would you?
You can probably tell by my accent that I'm no city slicker. I come from a small farm surrounded by bogland on the edge of civilization, /County Tyrone. Up Tyrone, yeah, up Tyrone, yeah. Have you noticed the way Gaelic football supporters do that? They prefix their county with the word up. So up Tyrone, up Fermanagh. County down, people just sound silly when they do that, don't they? Up down. But it really freaks me out whenever County Armagh supporters say it. I come from a small place called Killymuck, which you never heard of. There's lots of places in Tyrone that begin with the word kill, which must have been a nightmare during the Troubles, especially if you get stopped by the army.
Excuse me, sir, where are you coming from?
Killing a man.
And where are you going to?
Kill more. There really are some cracking place names in this country. There really are. Some of them are Scottish, some of them are Irish, some of them are Latin, some of them are English. The English ones, they're pretty easy to figure out why they named that place. Like of Coal Island, for example. That's an island where you go and buy coal. Cookstown. Well, that's a town where cooks go to cook things. Sausages, maybe. But what in the annals of history were they thinking whenever they named a place Drumahoe? Like, did they gather women of the night or something into big groups and pummel them with sticks to a rhythm? Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. That whore's out of tune.
Hello there and welcome here to A Wonder of Willie. Oh, I'm your host, Willie, and it's my job to take you on a wee wonder round the high roads and the by roads of this great green lawn. Charlie Baller. Charlie Baller here is one of the most famous storytellers in the area, a great musician, and one of the first men in Ireland to get a note out of a orthopedic shoe. But there's a very sinister tale behind this house in the area, isn't there? That's right, Tommy. Charlie here is telling me that in 1822, 39 people were killed by a herd of stampeding sheep. 7 were badly burned, just over there, by the wall, over there. Very tragic. but it sure did get the Dippers tuning them up. And that reminds me of a wee song. Charlie was telling me that in 1822, 39 people were killed here by a herd of stampeding sheep. Five of them were badly burned just over there by the wall over there. Very tragic, but it's sure to get the reapers turning on them up.
What a lovely boy.
Drip's turned full of rare characters, I'm telling you. Now I'm away to meet an 8-year-old fiddling champion from Ballabunion. He's the greatest kiddie fiddler in Ireland.
But it must be fantastic being a weatherman here with these names. How do they not go home laughing at night?
Heavy showers are coming in from the north coast, down past Limavady, down towards the Leek area. So if you are going out and about tomorrow, make sure you wear your waterproofs, especially if you're going to Leek.
And they say things with that plummy accent, and that's so that they can get away with saying this stuff.
Any show on will see the worst of the flooding. So if you are going to Donegal this weekend, be sure to wrap up warm and stay dry, especially around the Muff area.
But I think that these guys know exactly what they're doing, you know, but they try to hide the fact by making it personal, by showing you a picture that somebody sent in, or a birthday greeting or something like that.
And a special hello to my wife who's away on a girls' weekend to Mount Stewart. Although she assures me, time permitting, she'll try to get to Mount Hamilton as well.
Where am I crouched in a wheelie bin on the Malone Road at 7 a.m. on a Sunday morning? Pamela Ballantyne is about to walk out of that door wearing the same clothes she had on her last night. And that's not her house. It's her mate's house, but who's to know that? Cash in the bank. No need paparazzo in Belfast. Does that make me a pioneer? A maverick? Maybe. Maybe not. But if, for example, someone like Mary Peters was to fall out of the beach club at 3 o'clock in the morning with her tights around her ankles, you can guarantee Mozzie Marks would be the first man on the scene. Also, her tattler would be all over me like Lindsay Lohan on a blue wicket. If I don't do it, who will? Shit! All right, Pommy! Oh, that's a lovely dress you're wearing. Looks like the same one you'd on your last night, love.
Piss off,
Pommy. Oh, go on, you girl, yeah. Shit.
Just as a home stands on its grounds, the quality of a home stands and falls on the quality of its grounds. And these grounds really are a luxury. Just look at them. A mix of flora and fauna. Wonderful wide open spaces. A perfect place to practice the old golf swing. What could be nicer than blasting ball after ball over the heads of neighbours less fortunate than yourself? Watching all the girls
go by. Being a rugby man, the quality of the grass reminds me of my younger days, when I looked like a young Robert Redford with Brian O'Driscoll's frame. Haven't got a girl, but I can wish. Of course, the closest I get to a game these days is when big Jackie Fullerton weighs in at 4 o'clock in the a.m. with a conga line of stag and henders from the M Club for a few flaming sambucas and a game of touch.